Guys, in this video, we walk through how to build a simple app with LangChain and Chainlit. LangChain is an amazing framework that allows you to work with large language models. This framework is a game changer to build applications powered by language models. Another new framework is Chainlit. This framework helps you create applications integrated with LangChain. Today, we are going to call an LLM model from OpenAI using LangChain. And then, we are going to boot a chatbot with Chainlit. To do this, I am going to use VS Code. First, let's create a file named app.py. App.py. Okay, we've created a file. After that, we are going to set our OpenAI API key with the OS module to work with an LLM in OpenAI. You can find your OpenAI key in the website of OpenAI. To do this, go to OpenAI website. First, sign in or sign up for your OpenAI account. Once logged in, click on your profile name, then select the View API Keys option like this. Here, you will see a list of existing secret keys. You can select Create New Secret Key to generate a new key, then click the green icon on the pop-up page to copy your OpenAI secret key to a safe place. Nice! We've seen how to get an OpenAI API key. Let's set the OpenAI API key. To do this, let's import the OS module. Import OS. Let's use the env method to set our OpenAI API key. os.environ. Let's write OpenAI API key equals your OpenAI API key. Awesome! We set our API key. What we are going to build is a chatbot. To do this, let's first create a template for the prompt. Template equals, let's write question, curly brackets, let's set question, answer, let's think step by step. Nice, we've created our template. To return a question, let's create a function. To do this, let's use the LangChain factory decorator for the LangChain library. First, let me import Chainlit. Import Chainlit as CL. Let's create the function at cl.langchainfactory. Let's use the async parameter, pass it to true. Okay, we are ready to create the function. Let's write dev factory. Now, let's create prompt template. To do this, we are going to use the prompt template class in LangChain. First, let's import this class from langchain.prompts import prompt template. And then let's write prompt equals prompt template. Let's write template equals. Let's give this parameter to the template variable we created above, template. After that, let's set the input variables parameter input variables equal, let's pass question. Awesome! We've got a prompt template. To combine this template and the language model, let's use the chains. The simplest and most common type of chain is an LLM chain. Let's import this chain from langchain.chains import LLM chain. Now, let's create an example from class LLM chain equals LLM chain prompt equals prompt. Now, we are going to set our LLM model from OpenAI. First, let's import this class from LangChain LLMs import OpenAI. After that, LLM equals OpenAI. Let's give, since we don't want the output to be random, we will initialize our model with a temperature of 0. Temperature equals 0. To print the response text, let's use the verbose parameter. Verbose equals, let's give true. Lastly, let's use the return keyword to get a prediction. Return LLM chain. Nice! We've created our function for the chatbot. It's time to run our app. To start your LLM app, let's open a terminal. Next, navigate to the directory containing app.py. After that, let's write chainlit run app.py dash W. The dash W flag tends chain it to enable auto reloading. Let's hit enter. Nice! Our app is built. Our chatbot UI was opened localhost. You can delete the text here if you want. To do this, let's modify the chainlit md file. Let me go back. VS Code. Click chainlit. What we are going to do is just leave this file empty. Let's go to our chatbot UI. We can write anything here. Let's say, which is the most populated city in the world. Our chatbot is thinking. Here you are. If you wish, you can continue this conversation or you can start a new chat here. That's it. In this video, we have built a simple LLM app using Chainlit and LangChain. We will build more complex apps in the next video. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and like the video. See you in the next video. Bye for now.